Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another tutorial in Revit Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to show you how to create line vertical extend mullion for facade in Revit. Okay, so before I get started, I would like to ask you if you haven't subscribed to my channel, make sure hit subscribe button below and turn off phone notification for learn more about Revit. Okay, so the tutorial, just a quick tutorial. Let's follow along together. As you can see over there, here I am in Revit architecture interface. So I would like to go into open back my previous tutorial that Revit was based on that project. So I'm going to file there. Finding for my previous tutorial is rotation facade. If you want to know how to create those kind of facade, I will put link in description. You can take a look from that. Okay, so as you can see over there is my previous tutorial that we create those kind of rotation mullion, and I want to turn off facade first. So now we want to create extension for vertical line mullion for our facade in combined with our curtain glass storefront over there. So I would like to go to my, let's say we go to my level 2 first, because we start from level 2. And now I want to edit type, and then I change this one. Let's say we need to duplicate first, duplicate, then change this one for line vertical, line vertical extend frame. Okay, so I can hit finish first. After that, I can go to copy, then I can copy from here until here. Okay, so now file is generating. Hit escape first, so I can go to my 3D over there. As you can see, we got our double layer for storefront, but this one we will convert to our frame by using our mullion profile. This one I would like to change first, just select my previous one and change this one to basic storefront. And for rotation there, I would like to change it for 0, 0, and this guy as well. Make it 0, 0 for vertical and horizontal. Okay, so now for it generating again. Okay, perfect. So what I'm going to do next, I select my new mullion here. Sorry, not mullion, my new curtain wall here that I did type one for new family. So I can hit HI on my keyboard for hidden element. And for this one, I'm going to select all, then go to edit type. Make for vertical grid there, change this one to 2 meter, then I can hit apply. Okay, perfect. Now what I'm going to do next, I want to edit mullion profile to my vertical extend line. So I can go to my file over there and go to new family English. Finding kind of metric profile mullion, this one I can click here and open, or you can double click. Okay, so now I read on my profile mullion. What I'm going to do, I want to create some reference first. RP on my keyboard for reference, I just simply drag up here for horizontal and vertical as well. Okay, sorry, make it straight. Hit escape first, give a dimension, DI for dimension. I can make this one equal and here as well. Okay, let's assign a new parameter. Hit escape first, I select my 360 there, then I can assign a new parameter. Let's say we give this name for width. Okay, so DI again for dimension, hit escape, select 295 over there and change this one, assign new parameter here. Let's say this one is depth. Okay, so let's testing our family over there. Go to family type, let's say we change this one to 300 and make this one all 200 and hit apply. Okay, make this one 200 and here is 300. 120 for 200. Okay, perfect. Let's create our mullion profile. Go to create tab over there, select line, rectangle, start from the top corner over here until here, then make sure you lock all your component line. Hit escape first. Let's testing our final one. Let's say we change this one for 300 and make this one for 150, and I can hit apply. Okay, perfect. So I want to change that for 200 and make this one for 120. I can hit finish first, then I can load to my project here, load into my project for rotation facade here, go to our 3D. Okay, so now we load our Mullion profile. What I'm going to do, I just select my whole system over there. Sorry, I can select it, hits a tab key on my keyboard for select only my Mullion. Then I can right click on my cursor, go to select all entrance, but in the case done, we need to select take for visible in view, don't take for in interim project. Then I can go to unpick here and go to edit type over there. I can duplicate my Mullion profile because I don't want to affect my previous Mullion. I change this one for extend frame facade. For construction profile here, I'm going to change it for family 3 that we create profile here, so I can hit finish. Okay, now as you can see, our Mullion is changing, so we need to hide our glass first, zoom in a bit, then I can hit a tab key on my keyboard, then I can right click again, select and visible again, unpick again, then change from system panel glass to empty. Okay, so now I got all my frame here. I can HR on my keyboard for reverb that element, but not what I want, as you can see, because the frame is not bigger, it's too thin. So by change the system here, family here, you need to go to your family over there. Then drop down finding for profile. As you can see, here is our profile. I can open here, double click, and I can testing my profile here until what I want. Let's say I want for depth is 500 and make this one is 450, and I can hit OK first. Okay, I want more bigger than that, so I can double click again. And let's change our depth to 1000. Okay, perfect. So now I'm going to turn on for graphic display option, shadow, cast shadow, and show ambient shadow, and hit apply. Then hit finish. And this one, go to my level 2. I can select my whole system, then I can move nearer a bit. This, and of course in reality construction you might be need to add beam over there for mounting with your facade, with your concrete wall or shear wall with your reinforcement. Okay, so now I want to go back to my 3D. Okay, let's make it more interesting. I just like my Mullion there, right click, then go to my select all entrance invisible view, and I can right click again, go to override graphic by element, and let's make it more colorful. Let's say we change for this color darker a bit, then I can hit OK, then I can hit apply, then hit finish again. Okay, go to navigate here, then we can, let's say what I want to do, I can pick here. Okay, here, scale first, just leave it like this first, and boom, you done your vertical frame facade in Revit. And of course you can select your whole system here, sorry, your whole system over there, and you can play around with your rotation angle there. Okay guys, I think it's pretty much for this tutorial, just a quick one. Thank you guys for joining me from start to finish, and I hope you got learn something new about that. Thank you guys again, and make sure hit subscribe button below and turn off for notification for learn more about Revit, and I see you for another tutorial in Revit. Thank you.